Good morning, my siblings in Christ. It's so good to see you here today. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers and those who offer fatherly care. This is the third Sunday after Pentecost, and we begin our service with confession and forgiveness. Please stand as you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who greets us in this and every season, whose word never fails, and whose promise is sure.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of our neighbors. Merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned. We have hurt our community. We have squandered your blessings. We have hoarded your bounty. In the name of Jesus, forgive us and grant us your mercy.
Righteous God,
we confess that we have sinned. We have failed to be honest. We have lacked the courage to speak. We have spoken falsely. In sending Jesus, forgive us and grant us your mercy.
God is a cup of cold water when we thirst. God offers boundless grace when we fail. Claim the gift of God's mercy. You are free and forgiven. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Our gathering song is All People That Dwell on Earth Do All. Let me start again. All People That on Earth Do Well. 883 in the ELW.
Thank you. have opened the way for us and brought us to yourself. Pour your love into our hearts, that overflowing with joy, we may freely share the blessings of your realm and faithfully proclaim the good news of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated. First reading is taken from the 19th chapter of the book of Exodus, starting at verse 2. The Israelites had journeyed from Rephidim, entered the wilderness of Sinai, and camped in the wilderness. Israel camped there in front of the mountain. Then Moses went up to God, and the Lord called to him from the mountain, saying, "Thus you shall say to the house of Jacob, and tell the Israelites, you have seen what I did to the Egyptians, and how I bore you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. Now therefore, if you obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession out of all peoples. Indeed, the whole earth is mine, but you shall be for me a priestly kingdom and a holy nation. These are the words that you shall speak to the Israelites." So Moses came, some of the elders of the people, and set before them all these words that the Lord had commanded him. The people all answered as one, "Everything that the Lord has spoken, we will do." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will say Psalm 100 responsibly. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come to God's presence with a song.
Know that the Lord is God, our Maker, to whom we belong. We are God's people and the sheep of God's pasture.
Enter the gates of the Lord with thanksgiving and the courts with praise. Give thanks. Bless God's holy name.
Good indeed is the Lord, whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from age to age.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation. Of the Samaritans,
But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as you go, proclaim the good news. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, and cast out demons. You receive without payment and give without payment. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. Can my friends come up? Are you able to come up? That April said, make a joyful noise. So how do we make joyful noises? With instruments? Yeah. So what I need your help to do, I'm wearing my TLC hat because, you know, TLC guys and me do all kinds of good works around here. Besides eating donuts and drinking coffee. But so what I want you to do is help me pass out these instruments to people in the congregation. Can you do that with me? Let's go. Should we give one to your sister? She likes things. All right. And do you think April wants one? How about Diane? Can you give her one to pass down to me? You need two for that. And how about this young couple here, Cliff and Sandy? Can you give her the other part? Okay. And how about this couple here? This is Bob and Tina. Do you think that is another one left in the room? And how about this father and his daughter? Should we give one to Doug the other one? Gracious God, we come to worship. Sometimes we look around and we see our friends and those people we care about, and we have compassion on them. And we pray for those who are traveling and who are not with us this day. But you have called us to be here at this time and at this moment, to touch our hearts, to strengthen our minds, so that we may go out too and tell others that the kingdom of God is here. O God, may the words from my lips and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you, our rock and our salvation. Amen. So, Lord, we have that. You can tell the guys. So, when I was serving on staff at Central State Synod, my job was events and resources. And we had a program in the Senate called Partnership for Missional Church. As a staff, we read this gospel story, but Luke's version instead, every week for a year. The same passage. Every week. And every time we read it, we were supposed to say what caught our attention. And every week, I would say, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers for God's harvest. Because I was struggling in my role as a band planner to get volunteers to come forward. You know, you send out little notes to congregations and say, put this in your bulletin or announce this at your congregation. And, you know, it just didn't give me enough volunteers, not enough laborers. And then I thought, think about this, Cynthia. What do you need to do? I need to go out and talk to people and find out their gifts and their passions, their interests, their talents. And in doing that, I could bring them in to volunteer. Aha! Eureka! Let's make a joyful noise! Jesus sending out the 12 disciples to proclaim the kingdom of God has come here. and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to cure every disease and every sickness. Yet Jesus tells them to only go to the lost sheep of Israel. Stay away from the Gentiles and the Samaritans, which is kind of troubling to me. And yet, you know, sometimes the most difficult people to get on board with a new idea, a new concept, a new way of doing God's work are the insiders. Because they have trouble seeing a new way of being. Some of those on the inside are so stuck in their ways, they can't see a new way of thinking. And those who think they're on the inside are also lost in their thinking and understanding. They can't see the forest or the trees. So I understand why Jesus starts with these disciples going to the lost sheep of Israel. But as this passage goes on, Jesus also tells them that they are to go out and no payment. And in the following verses that I didn't read, Jesus says, take no gold or silver or copper in your belt, no bag for your journey or two tunics or sandals or a staff, for the laborers deserve their food. Whatever town you enter, find out who is worthy and stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, reach it. If the house is worthy, let your peace come to it. But if it's not, let your peace return to you. If anyone does not welcome you or listen to your words, shake the dust off your feet as you leave that house. You know there's a ritual for that. Shaking the dust off the feet. You kick like this. All right, a joyful noise. Truly, I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah than on that day of judgment for that town. See, I am sending you out like sheep into the midst of wolves. So be wise as serpents and innocent as doves. Are you crazy, Jesus? We are to carry nothing with us, and you want us to, it's going to be dangerous out there, Jesus. Are you sure this is what you want us to do? Do you think we're up to the task? Jesus says, yeah, you got this. You've been with me for a while. You see what I've done. You've got this. And these 12 go out. And in Luke's version, they go out in pairs. And as they go out, they are amazed at what happens. How they are able to do good work, to heal the sick, to cast out demons. They are astonished. It's like they come back home after their journeys and they say, Jesus, you won't believe what happened. He said, yeah, I told you. I knew what was going to happen.
Insiders, but those
field, they are outsiders, and that God cares for them, that God loves all people because they are all a part of God's creation. As the psalmist says, make a joyful noise to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness and come into God's presence with song. Make a joyful noise. Let it be so. Amen.
Paul.
your creation, and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
Next week, The Chosen, we will meet and we'll watch episodes 4 4 and 5 of the first season. Flower charts, there are some openings, so please take a look at that. And Hy-Vee does a wonderful job. I'm just saying. For $30, we can't do it. So please look at that. Pizza and conversation on the fourth Wednesday. Please sign up for that so we know you're coming. And Diane has an announcement.
We're going to collect household batteries. So please bring them here, put them in this labeled container. It's in the little room back here. And I will take them to Doremus that takes all the toxic things. So please do that.
Dead or alive?
Any other announcements? Connie has an announcement.
The annual fundraiser for Metro Lutheran Ministries is held earlier this year, September 16th, and for the first time ever, it'll be in the Northland. Usually drive way so. So it's at the Old Mill Emporium in Parkville, which is just south of the railroad tracks, September 16th from 6 to 11 p.m. It's a different format than previously. It's one we call the Gala, before that, the Power of Each One, but this is called Ready, Set, Feast, and it's a party. So there won't be a plate of meal. Your ticket will buy you the opportunity to go through a number of food stations, pairing drinks, cocktails with the food. And there'll be a lot of mingling. There aren't reserved tables unless we can pop up $2,500 for a reserved table. But there are tables. There's plenty of seating. There'll be a silent auction, a DJ dancing, games, some outdoor games, I guess, as well. And tickets are on sale now, $125 for a single ticket. In the past, we've had a generous congregant who's purchased a table for $1,000, and we can do that. And our name will go in the program as far as, you know, St. James, but you'll still have to find your own chair. But anyway, I hope a lot of you will be able to go. It's a fun evening, and the fact that it's in Parkville, I mean, it's down the street. So there's more information on the MLE.